Welcome to a new test and teardown video. Well, I don't know how much tests and how much teardown there's going to be in this video. I'm going to play a little bit with this really nice X-ray tube. As you can see it here in my hand, it is really, really big. And it's also very, very heavy, especially down in this end. And I believe this is because the anode here is made of solid copper, and all this is also copper, and there's bearings and all that stuff. And also this tungsten anode, it's a rotating anode that's in here. And let me try and show you guys the rotating anode. See, if I take and move the glass here, you can see I moved the glass, right? And you can see the anode is still in there. And that's of course because of the mechanical mass. See, if I move slowly, I could probably spin it up. Isn't that just funny? So the ball bearings just really, really low friction. Otherwise this could not, not be possible, right? But it's just, I don't know if I'm getting weak in my fingers, but I'm also really afraid of dropping this, because I guess that's going to say quite a big kaboom here if this is going to happen. So it's from Siemens, a Bi 150-30-101R, I guess. So here's the fabrication number. If anybody know how to Google this and find the exact specification sheet with all the slimy details, I would be very interested. I can only find similar tubes, not exactly this one. They look a lot like this if you kind of just look briefly on them. So the size is more or less the same, and it fits of course in all sorts of fine equipment. But they're a little bit different in the cathode design. This one is a double cathode, or double filament. I don't know if it's easy to see here, but it's also easy to see on the number of wires here, because we've got three wires. And the way that I figure this out is we've got a small and a large filament coil. And that will be the different colors of the wires. So let me just give this a little bit of voltage so we can see what's going on here. Yeah, so look at this, is the red and the black wire. So that will be the smallest filament. And you can also see on the wire on the anode. So that will be the small beam. Or the narrow, I guess. So this is where it's gonna hit. And then if you look at the angle it's made, so it's actually hitting here and then it's directed out this window. So they cut a piece of the glass here so it's thinner, but also so it's more clean. So it's not bumpy or anything. They want a nice clean radiation pattern. So if you look in here, let me try and power up the other one while I hold the camera here. Just too bad I don't have the motor or the coils. Is actually, well, I don't know what is the motor. The motor is both the stator and the rotor, right? That is the motor. But the coils, they're normally mounted out here. They're more or less the same size as all this, but I don't have this. So here's how I want to demonstrate the motor, just by placing a magnet here and see what happens if I move the magnet. See, I can actually move the magnet and then this way rotate the anode. Yeah, okay, this magnet is not powerful Yeah, look. See? It is possible to move it. So that's what I'm saying. So that is, of course, done by coils, but it's still possible to do it with a little tiny magnet. That's quite cute. Let me see if I can show you this. I want you to look at this area of the glass. Try and see if you can see it's actually a little bit darker where all the X-ray is coming out. So it's actually decolored or added a little bit of material. It's something happened to the glass. It could also be a filament material and like cathode material hammering down here on the anode, and some of it's actually ejected to the glass and is now sitting here on the glass, tiny, tiny little particles. I don't know how old this is or how many hours this can run before it's changed. There's definitely still a vacuum in this one since the filaments are working, but I don't know if it's deep, super, super vacuum needed to be able to generate X-ray, but at least it can run the filaments quite well. I'm definitely going to play a little bit more with this during the next few days and hopefully add a little bit of extra minutes to this video. I just want to show you if it wants to. Why don't it want to rotate? You can see they balanced the tungsten. And tungsten is a very, very interesting material. Of course, it's insanely heavy. And I guess this is also what I can feel here, the weight of this. But it's very, very high melting point is, of course, also a very, very important parameter for choosing this material. Like I said, I don't have exact data for this, but for some similar tubes, and I've been reading something about 81 kilovolts and 125 milliamps. And if this is at the same time and for I don't know how many minutes or that is, but that is 10,000 watts of anode current. So I would imagine if this is true, I would imagine this one would go a million degrees hot. But there's probably a thermal conductivity between the rotating anode, and this is of course the real anode electrode. This one is solid copper or brass, and when I touch this, I can feel it's just ice cold, and it's just still really, really cold. I had this thing in here for a few hours. It was of course in the trunk of the car, but it's still really, really cold. So there must be a huge amount of thermal mass in this. Yeah, why is this so ice cold? That is funny. Of course I can heat it up and then it's going to stay hot for a long, long time. But that is really, really funny. So here is a little science project. I got the tube wired up with a little bit of filament. Of course this is a very, very low filament, so there's not going to be any emission at this level. I can see where the tube is a little bit dark, and I guess that is the sweet spot of where emission is going out the tube, and I'm pointing that output directly into my Geiger counter. What you hear here is a background radiation. So, and this is only a 6,000 volt supply, and it can only give 2 milliamps current limited. So the only thing I wanted to see if I'm able to get just a little bit extra counts on the Geiger counter. So the trick is, let's just crank up the high voltage. Here we go. So now we got 6,000 volts on the tube, and then I'm going to crank up the filament. See, we don't hear anything at all. There's no change whatsoever. So this is only eight volts. Nothing. Boring. So here's experiment two. I had a few problems with the Geiger counter being way too loud, and also my power supply for filament overdriving and shutting down and all that kind of stuff. So now I'm just gonna crank up the anode supply first, like. Did not work. Let me try and do that. Crank it up. Okay. Here we go. So now we got only 6,000 volts. And I am then going to try and crank up the filament. Hopefully I'll get just a little bit emission for the Geiger counter. So this is 12 volts and it's very, very bright, but we don't hear anything. So I abort this first experiment. So in a desperate attempt to get some high voltage for the X-ray tube, I picked up this funny machine from one of my buddies who made this one. It's using standard ignition coils in push-pull, and they are running in, of course, in flyback mode. So that means the one is going positive and the other one is going negative. And the distance between that point and that point here is actually 35 millimeters. So let's try and see if this works. So all I have to do is push this little ignition. Oh my God. So that is definitely some crazy stuff. Let's crank down the. A little bit more. Yeah, so this is definitely enough, I should expect. I will only use one of them because I only want positive, so I will disable the negative one and then I will try it with the X-ray tube. This is the test setup, of course. It's a little bit funny. Let's try and listen to the Geiger counter here, if it says anything. Are you ready? Did you hear that? So the Geiger counter definitely says something. Oh, that is interesting. So every time I push, let me go down. Give it. Oh yeah. We got X-ray. clearly visible. Can you hear that? Oh yeah, that is definitely X-ray. No problemo.